Andy in Scituate has something for Tony Mazz here. Go ahead, Andy.
Hey, Tony.
Yes.
Stop it with the conspiracy theories. You want to hear a conspiracy theory?
Sure.
I think you enjoy watching Boston teams lose. First of all, they said the Sox are going to miss the playoffs. Did you watch Clay Buchholz pitch last night? I am never going to read a BBW, whatever you call it, piece of literature again because it's just pessimism.
Attaboy, Andy.
Second of all, you said the Sox.
Hold on. We're going to boycott the BBWAA. That means you can't read anyone locally, Andy, but I think it's a good place to start. I'm sorry. Go ahead.
That's okay. Second of all, you said the Celtics are getting a crush last night.
I did.
Do you get that the Knicks are a shooting team, okay? Shooting teams win a few rounds in a fight, okay? A Celtics, a full team, they'll go 15 rounds and they'll come out on top. Third of all, 2 years ago, you compared the Patriots to the Falcons.
Yes, I did. That's
right. When's the last time the Falcons won a Super Bowl? Vietnam? then you told me for trading Andrew Luck for Tom Brady. What's going on here?
No, what I said,
Where's
Andy,
Boston love?
I said they had turned into the Falcons is what I said. I didn't say they were the Falcons. They had turned into the Falcons. That's all I said. But I'm glad he came well-armed for the show today. Can't say I blame him on the Celtics. Look, I whiffed. I whiffed as badly as you can whiff on that one. I thought when it was 11-0, I said, here we go. This is it. Runaway train, man. They are going to get their asses kicked tonight. And then by the end of the first quarter, it's 22-20. At halftime, they're up. And I'm sitting there saying, how are they even in this thing? And then by the time it got to the fourth quarter and they went up 15 early in the fourth quarter, I said,
but Maz, tell me this quickly.
Sure.
30 seconds. Outside of their shots going in, some of the prayers that Jeff Green threw up or Terry threw up, aside of some of their three balls going in, how did they do it?
They protected the basketball better for the first three quarters, Mike. I mean, I think that was a big one. And honestly, Garnett was more engaged in the game on both ends, offensively and defensively. He was a threat offensively. And so when he didn't shoot, he passed. Again, he had five assists last night. So Garnett and Jason Terry, to me, were the two best players on the floor. Now, can they repeat it? I don't know. But if those two guys play like that, they can win the next two.